morning, friends. Let us have a session on multi-stage flash evaporation, one of the techniques of desalination of water. In my previous sessions, videos, I have discussed with some other techniques of desalination of water, one of the most important being the reverse osmosis. Now, in order to understand the multi-stage flash evaporation technique, we should have a basic idea of something called as boiling point. Now, what is a boiling point of a liquid? Technically, a boiling point of a liquid is the temperature wherein the vapor pressure of the liquid is equal to atmospheric pressure. It is the temperature at which the vapor pressure of the liquid is equal to atmospheric pressure. Quoting an example, in case of water, the boiling point of water at 1 bar pressure is observed to be 100 degrees Celsius. That means at 100 degrees Celsius, vapor pressure of water will be equal to atmospheric pressure. Vapor pressure of the water will be equal to atmospheric pressure. Now, using this fundamental idea, what if I decrease the atmospheric pressure? Now, if I decrease the atmospheric pressure, the temperature required by any liquid to reach the atmospheric pressure or to convert its vapor pressure to atmospheric pressure will be low. That means at lower temperature, vapor pressure will be equal to atmospheric pressure provided I have decreased the atmospheric pressure. And this is the basic idea what we are using in multi-stage flash evaporation technique. So, in the multi-stage flash evaporation technique, we pass the steam or the brine through multiple evaporation units wherein there is a continuous decrease in the atmospheric pressure, which will account to the fast evaporation of water, and we obtain the fresh water out of brine. We will observe that phenomena using the diagram.
So let's have an understanding using the diagram of multi-stage flash vaporization or flash evaporation. The brine or salt water is passed into the condensing coils, which is in turn connected to the heater over here. The hot brine is passed into the flash chambers. I've got two chambers over here. Now if you observe in the flash chamber, so this chamber 1 operates at a pressure P, and the chamber 2 operates at pressure P1, which is lower than pressure P. So when the hot brine or sea water enters into the first flashing unit at a lower pressure compared to that of the atmospheric pressure, the water starts evaporating. These vapors of the water are again collected at the condensing unit over here, and the fresh water flows out. The brine further moves into the second flashing unit where the pressure is lower than the first flashing unit. At a low pressure, again the water starts to evaporate. The vapors of the water are condensed at the condensing coil and they are collected as fresh water. The unused brine is passed maybe into the next and the forthcoming flashing units, and again it can be recycled by passing through the heater. So this ends the process of multi-stage flash evaporation, wherein decreasing the pressure at multiple units of the flashing chambers, you can get the fresh water out of brine. Thank you.